Hello Android developers! My name is Mohsen and in this Android developer tips video, I want to show you how easy it is to switch your app's build.gradle file from Groovy language to the familiar Kotlin Script language. Before I start, please do not forget that you can support this channel by subscribing and sharing the videos. And by hitting the bell button, you will get notified when there is a new video. Let's start. Since the beginning of the Gradle build system for Android apps, we've got to deal with unfamiliar Groovy language. But as usual, Kotlin is here for rescue. Android Gradle plugin version 4 added support for using Kotlin Script, also known as KTS, in your Gradle build configuration as a replacement for Groovy. It means for every config or command in your build.gradle file, there is an equivalent to letting you change it to a build.gradle.kts file. As a quick demo, I will provide you with basic information about converting your Android app's Gradle build file from Groovy to KTS using my sample app. My suggestion is to migrate one file at a time and after migration, build the whole project to make sure everything is fine. You can rename the build.gradle file and add .kts to the end of it and sync the project to start noticing broken points in this file. In this file, the first issue is related to class path method. In Groovy, you can call methods without parentheses, but in Kotlin, you need to explicitly add the method call parentheses. Also, while Groovy allows the strings to be defined using single quotes, Kotlin requires double quotes, therefore you need to replace all of them. In the end, the clean task should be defined like this. Now we can sync and build the project to make sure the first file is done and the app runs normally. Let's go to the app module build.gradle file and add the KTS extension to that file. Applying plugins is similar in Groovy and KTS. In both languages, we use the plugin block to add plugins. Do not forget that id is a method and requires the parentheses, and we should replace all single quotes with double quotes. As you know, all the variables also require assignment in Kotlin. In the Kotlin DSL, certain build types such as debug and release are available implicitly. Other build types, however, must be created manually. Some variables are renamed that you can easily find their equivalent by pressing Ctrl or Command space. Plus, if you have special blocks like this project's source sets, you may require to Google and find how they should be done case by case. In such cases, my favorite trick is to search GitHub repository for those keywords and filter them by the file type. Also, a tip is to look into the source code of the plugin by pressing Ctrl click or Command click shortcut to understand the data type and usage. Regarding dependencies, we also do the same, adding parentheses to implementations and test implementations, and replacing single quote with double quote. You should also replace all defs with Kotlin family or val. It looks like I broke something related to bomb dependencies. Okay, problem solved. Now we can do the sync and test the app again. One last bonus tip is that you can use the Kotlin method for Kotlin plugins and remove the Kotlin part or full package name from their names. Although KTS currently offers better integration in Android Studio's code editor when compared to Groovy, builds using KTS tend to be slower than builds using Groovy, so migrating to KTS should be considered with build performance in mind. As usual, please subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and don't forget to like and share this video with your teammates or other Android developers. Hope you enjoyed this video and keep doing great apps. See you soon in another Android Developer Tips video. Bye bye.